If you grew up in my era, the golden age of Brand Jordan, it's back. Yo, what's good, guys? This is Nightwing2303 from WearTesters.com. Today we got another 90s classic. This is the first time this shoe has been retroed ever. We haven't seen these in like 20 years, man. This is crazy. For those of you guys that don't know, this is Eddie Jones. I guess it's his second signature shoe. So these guys right here are the Jumpman Pro Quicks. Eddie Jones used to rock these. This is his first technical signature sneaker with Jordan Brand. Played in these well with the Lakers as well as with the Miami Heat later on down the line. And these guys right here are his second sneaker. So it's basically the successor to the Pro Quick. And these were called the Quick 6, now renamed to the Quick 23. But I'm not calling them that. They will forever be the Jumpman Pro Quick 6 to me. And like I said earlier, we haven't seen these in 20 years, man. It's been too long. Like, this is crazy. Like, this, for someone like me that grew up in the 80s and the 90s and was a teenager in the late 90s, just this golden era of basketball shoes, like, it's back. I mean, this is what's popping. It's what's always been popping in my mind. Some can say that I never like grew out of whatever it is that I was into, which I would never disagree with that because it's completely true. I mean, look at my shirt. I mean, come on, man, I didn't grow up ever. But those are the things that were awesome in my childhood, and I like to keep them around. Makes me feel youthful despite having all the gray hair and all that stuff. But enough rambling, these bad boys right here are fantastic. They stripped the tech out of these. They did the same thing in the Jumpman Pro. I was kind of pissed, and that's probably an understatement. But these guys right here, I actually never owned, so I don't have that type of emotional attachment to them. I've always wanted a pair, I just couldn't afford them. Back then, you only got really one pair of shoes a year, so it's a little bit different for me now and for most kids today as well. So this guy right here, I don't know what the original tech specs were. I can't find a freaking eBay clipping or anything of these shoes. I could find it of these, I could find it of those back there. Eddie Jones used to rock those too. That's the Jordan Team 1. Those are OGs. They need to bring back that colorway, man. Those are super fresh. But yeah, I can't find what the original tech specs were, so that's a bummer. But what these actually do offer in the retro version is a Phylon midsole, which is actually pretty comfortable just on its own. And then in the heel, we have an Air unit, and in the forefoot, we have a Zoom Air unit. So it's not really anything different than what we get today as far as like new basketball shoes go. The only real difference is that these guys are made up of mostly leather and a thick rubber outsole, which can be used for outdoors or indoors. I've said this many times before. A lot of people like to ask, like, what is the best hoop shoe for outdoors? There really is no best hoop shoe, period, just because it really depends on the person and their preferences, what they want or need or like out of a shoe. But if we're talking about outdoor hoops, if you're looking for something that's durable, that's gonna last, always look at the 90s stuff. It's always getting retroed. The cushion most of the time is still decent. Like these guys, like I said, that we still use Air and Zoom Air today in the same exact placements that they're in with the foam midsole, so it's not really anything different as far as today's standards. The only real difference, again, is that they're made durable. They're built to last. These guys are Ford tough. And what I loved about the team models back in the day, or the Jumpman series, is that the design team that was in charge of these shoes perfectly blended little elements, not crazy elements, just small little details from the signature sneakers, and they put them in a brand new design. So it never felt or looked like a mashup. But if you were a fan of the brand and the products that they were releasing, you would be able to hold this, look at it, and be like, oh, this is from this shoe or from that shoe. And to me, that was kind of cool. It was almost like an Easter egg on a sneaker. So as you can see, we have a solid rubber outsole with herringbone, and there are plenty of flex grooves in there as well. Those white sections are actually rubber. It's not the foam underneath it. So again, just a real solid, durable rubber outsole. And then you have a TPU torsional shank plate there as well. Again, as far as today's standards go for basketball, this is no different. They still use the same stuff because this stuff is what works. I already talked about the tech specs, but like I was saying before, we have a Phylon midsole, heel Air unit, forefoot Zoom Air unit. The insole is ortholite. It's a real thin, cheap one, so nothing crazy, but I did find them to be very comfortable. And yes, these guys are 100% playable. And then we have a tumbled leather upper. So the tumbled sections that you see are actual leather. And then this blue portion right here on the forefoot originally was Nubuck, along with the leather piece on the tongue. That was Nubuck previously as well. Now it's a synthetic leather, which is kind of a bummer. So they're not exactly like the original, but they're super, super close. The original's little side panel right here where the air scoop was actually tumbled leather as well. These guys are a smooth synthetic. The air vent that's there is made up of a cheap kind of like plasticky looking material. The originals used to be metal, and this area right here was taken directly from the Air Jordan 14, which I think is awesome because that tiny little air scoop in the Air Jordan 14 was really cool. But having one on the lateral and medial side of the sneaker, I mean, it's even cooler. You can see the Ferrari Jordan logo right there on the heel. Again, that was taken directly from the Air Jordan 14. And then they even took little design elements from the Air Jordan 13, the rubber pods that are along the midsole. They actually used the same exact little dimple implementation right there along the midsole on these guys. Again, just little tiny things that you'll be like, oh man, that's cool. I remember when they did that on this shoe. And for a Jordan fan, like I said, back in the day, growing up in the 90s, this is what we could really afford. And even then, we could barely afford these. We definitely couldn't afford the top tier signature shoe. This guy right here was not a reduction in anything. It was just a new Jordan shoe and it was awesome. One other small difference that's different between these and the originals is that right here, this little plastic top eyelet, it originally had Eddie Jones logo on it. It no longer does, which I think is unfortunate. And what I wish that they had done was actually redid this area so that it mimicked the finish of the shank plate right there, almost looking like it does on the original Jumpman Pro Quick. It would have been awesome to have had a little Jumpman logo right there done up in a metallic midnight navy. I just think that would have been a really nice touch. It would have been different, but so is this. So, I mean, if you're gonna make it different, at least make it better. As far as fit is concerned, these guys fit true to size. And like I said before, they're super comfortable and 100% playable. I did take them out to the court. I didn't play any real games in them, but I was just kind of messing around, shooting around, and they feel really, really good. I love how everything is built, how it's made. The leather that they use is so soft that it just feels like it's broken in right from the jump. They smell good. I mean, this is a fantastic retro. So these guys retailed for $125. Again, I can't remember what they retailed originally. I'm pretty sure that $125 is more than what they originally retailed for. But to me personally, I do feel like my money was well spent, especially when you compare it to this, which is a shoe that I actually do prefer design-wise over this guy. But these guys right here, they just lack the tech, even though they really accomplished the look. Whereas these guys right here, they're ready to go. If you wanted to wear these casually, you're gonna be happy. If you wanted to wear these on court to relive some old memories, you're also gonna be happy. And that pretty much takes care of it for these guys, man. I don't know what else to say. I think that this is a fantastic sneaker. Again, Eddie Jones used to rock these. This is his second sneaker. He used to rock these when he was playing for the Charlotte Hornets. He has some really cool PEs of the shoe as well. It would be really cool if they released some of those colorways, although I doubt it, but you never know. So let me know what you guys think about the Jordan Pro Quick 6, also known as the Jordan Quick 23 now, but again, we're gonna ignore that. Sound off in the comment section below. Would you hoop in these? If you're looking for an outdoor shoe, this is a viable option. And if you just like hooping in real shoes, like shoes that are built well, this is a great shoe for indoor use as well. Kind of like the Kobe Protro, but not as iconic, I guess. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thanks for all your support. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Subscribe if you hadn't already. Hit the thumbs up button, it goes a long way. And until next time, guys, have a good one.